Hey guys, JJ from Rooster Teeth here to tell you that Sony has announced their PlayStation 4 console is now available in 48 countries after launching in Greece, Slovakia, Turkey, United Arab Emirates, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Qatar, Bahrain, Oman, South Africa, Bolivia, Nicaragua, Paraguay, Uruguay, Venezuela, and the Czech Republic. And if I'm pronouncing those wrongs, you can blame the US Education Department. The console, which sold 1 million units in its first 24 hours following its North American launch on November 15th and passed 2.1 million units 48 hours after its November 29th European launch, has completely sold out of available stock within 24 hours of its launch in South Africa and continues to be scarce on shelves in North America and the UK as Sony manufactures stock to attempt to meet the demand for Christmas. Sony is thrilled with the console's record-breaking sales performance so far. Senior VP Guy Longworth, by the way, awesome name, says, "Thanks for an unforgettable PS4 launch and for making 2013 such a historic year for gaming. We look forward to sharing exciting PS4 news with you in the near future." He also shares they'll have major announcements coming at E3 next June, though he doesn't hint at what kind of reveals they have planned and says they are working on adding additional console functionality to come in future system updates. Next up, Capcom has announced a new DLC for Dead Rising 3 called Operation Broken Eagle, which will be the first episode in the Lost Stories of Los Perdidos. The DLC will contain a new mission, 5 new weapons, a new combo weapon, a new vehicle, new fashion options, and of course, extra achievements. No word yet on pricing, but it will be available on December 24th, just in time for some Christmas Eve gaming. Finally, the sad story of 38 Studios, founded by baseball star Curt Schilling, continues after its bankruptcy last year. The state of Rhode Island, which took control of all the studio's property in an attempt to reclaim loans it made to the studio, has been frantically trying to offload as much of it as possible to recoup the cost. Earlier this year, they sold off the studio's equipment and office space, which recouped less than $1 million of the total debt, and scheduled an auction for November to offload the studio's IP and trademarks. The auction ended up being delayed until this month due to higher than expected interest from 20 different parties, but ultimately only 5 parties participated. 2 lots were sold to parties that haven't yet been disclosed. The first was for the IP rights to Rise of the Nations and Rise of the Empires game, and the other was for the Big Huge Games trademark. Sadly, the rights to Big Huge Games' planned MMO, Project Copernicus, failed to sell, and so did the rights to Kingdoms of Amalur, their ambitious action RPG that ultimately failed to perform commercially. Rhode Island indicates it might have had some offers, but nothing deemed acceptable to offset its losses. In total, the auction only raised $320,000 and didn't even make a dent in the remaining debt. And that's news today. Have you been lucky enough to find a PlayStation 4 on store shelves? Let us know in the comments. Then check out roosterteeth.com to learn more about our newest delivery options like catapults, teleportation, rogue Navy SEALs, and naked interns.